Now, I invite my friend Dr. Padmanabhan TV from Department of Yoga Studies, School of Public Health, Central University of Kerala. Actually, we had been together long back in Bihar Yoga Bharati as we did the post graduation there, and he had been also presented the talk, the scholarly talk, in the last 4th international conference in developing human values through yoga. So I invite Dr. Padmanabhan TV to deliver his talk in this national webinar. Dr. Padmanabhan TV.
Namaskaram. I am Dr. Padmanabhan TV, Department of Yoga Studies, Central University of Kerala. Om Sri Gurave Namaha. To my Guru Paramahamsa Swami Niranjananda Saraswati of Bihar School of Yoga. Swamiji said, yoga is a science of life, not science of body. First of all, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to the Vice Chancellor, Professor Dr. Devi Prasad Tripathi and Registrar Sri Girish Kumar Avasthi and to Dr. Kamakhya Kumar and his organizing team of Uttarakhand Sanskrit University for organizing the first and best webinar on yogic solution to mental problems during the corona crisis and lockdown period, and for inviting me as a resource person in the university webinar. So my topic is management of fear because of the fear of spreading coronavirus. Fear is one of the mental problems during coronavirus because of fear of getting sick. So before management of fear, we should know what fear is. Usually people perceive fear is a negative emotion. Is it true? Fear is a human emotion that is triggered by a perceived threat and help us for appropriate adaptive behavior to keep us safe from dangerous situations. Fear is a basic instinct. It is born with the human beings as a basic survival mechanism. All living beings have fear. For example, when a cobra is coming towards a small dog, the dog immediately runs back. Why it runs back? Because of fear. Here the fear protects the dog. So, bhai jo hai, wo ghabrane wala baat nahi hai. Bhai, kuch waqt par, kuch circumstance par, अच्छा होता है. सो नाउ वी आर अंडर फियर बिकॉज ऑफ द फियर ऑफ द प्रेजेंट कम्युनिकेबल डिजीज दैट इज द कोरोना वायरस. ऑफकोर्स वी डू एवरीथिंग टू प्रिवेंट द स्प्रेड ऑफ कम्युनिकेबल डिजीज मेनली बिकॉज ऑफ फियर ऑफ गेटिंग सिक. इट मीन्स फियर मोटिवेट्स अस टू मेक वाइज डिसीजंस व्हेन वी फेस सर्टेन फियरफुल सिचुएशंस. So we can compare this fear in a parabola curve, and in the parabola curve, when we draw a line in the center of that curve, that center line is called the optimum fear, that is healthy fear that we need for our survival, and the left side is the low fear. Low fear makes us very carelessness in life, and the right side is the high fear, and the high fear makes us sick. So yoga practice for management of fear. So Jyoti Tradaga is a powerful technique to remove the fear arising from the subconscious mind. Why Jyoti Tradaga is powerful? Because light is a symbol of divinity in all cultures and religions worldwide. The light is invoked as Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya, means lead me from darkness to light. Ignorance is darkness and knowledge is the light. In Jungian psychology, Carl Gustav Jung The fire or flame is a symbolic archetype which represents life and knowledge. The characteristics of an archetype is universal. A flame is a flame all over the world. The Rig Veda, the first and foremost of Vedas, starts with the hymn to adore Agni, the first of supreme cosmic powers. See the importance of the flame, you see the importance of the flame. And that is why, although there are many types of Tradaga, Jyoti Tradaga is a powerful technique, no doubt for that. So I am not going to discuss the practice of Tradaga, because you know that. Actually, what happens when we do Tradaga? So Tradaga is a process to train the mind to focus the scattered energy here and there of the mind like a magnifying glass onto one spot in the center of the brain. That result improving attention and concentration. Because of the fact that where energy flows, their attention goes. So when you look at the wick of the flame externally, your conscious mind is activated. And when we visualize the after image of the wick of the flame, remember this word, after image of the wick of the flame. In the psychic space called Chitakasha, our subconscious mind is activated. And what is subconscious mind? So it is the reservoir of all experiences, including memories, skills, thoughts, beliefs, emotions, which includes subconscious fears. You know that images and symbols are the language of subconscious mind. It has no written language at all. Suppose you are thinking about your house, the image of the house comes. Never the letter house comes. That is why we see pictures, images, symbols in dreams created by the subconscious mind. You don't worry about the dream. Dreams are the royal road of the unconscious mind. So the subconscious mind responds well to images and symbols. Hence, visualization is one of the well-established techniques to program the subconscious mind to eliminate or control the negative emotions, including fear. So Tradaga is a process to programming the subconscious mind. So let me conclude my speech. The daily practice of Tradaga, that is Abhyasa, what we do call in yoga, would help for the practice of the mental imagery of the flame even without physically practicing Tradaga. It means by daily practice what happens, the after image of the flame comes or it appears in the Chitakasha automatically. It is because of the practice. In other words, the golden flame becomes a psychic symbol for meditation, and this is Antartradaga actually. The psychic image of the flame which generates positive attitude. I already told that the Jyoti generates positive attitudes due to the divine characteristic of the flame as discussed by me earlier. This flame can be associated or paired with when we are under fear or we feel any other mental problems to reduce the intensity of the mental problems to a maximum extent. This technique is very similar to that of a psychological technique for eliminating phobia, fear or anxiety, etc., called systematic desensitization. Desensitization. It means the practice would help to desensitize the intensity of unpleasant experiences, and this is the greatness of Tradaga. So you do practice Tradaga every day, early morning at 6 o'clock and in the evening at 6 o'clock. You see these two timings, the dusk and dawn, the dawn and dusk, these are the two meeting points of the circadian rhythm. So there are many things to talk about Tradaga. So Tradaga is one of the great techniques of meditation besides its Shatkarma activities or process. Thank you very much to the organizing team. So let me conclude my talk by chanting the Shanti Mantra. ॐ लोका समस्ता सुखिनो भवन्तु ॐ शांति 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 हरि ही हो हरि ओम तत्सत्।